another video from Melanated Media News, where alternative thinking is as simple as breathing. Now, I know it's been a while, but we're undergoing some changes, and we hope that you like it. Now, today we're going to have a review on the blindspotting movie. As you know, gentrification is a major issue that we cover on this channel, so it's only fitting that we review this movie. Now, off the bat, this movie, I would give it a 4 out of 5. Very, very good, solid, original movie. Good cast, good script, good cinematography, all the technical aspects besides the social commentary. The movie is a good movie within itself. Some of the moments might have been kind of corny or whatever, but could have been better. But David Diggs, who plays Colin, I think he did an exceptional job. Even Cassell, the white guy in the movie from Oakland, who plays Miles, he did what he was casted to do. But Diggs, he's more... especially the scene towards the end with the cop. If you see the movie, you'll know what I'm talking about. I think that's going to be one of the best scenes of the year. And it wouldn't surprise me maybe if he gets some kind of Best Supporting Actor nomination. I'm not saying he is, but I wouldn't be surprised. I haven't seen a lot of other movies this year, so I don't know. But I think he did an exceptional job with that. Now, I got that out of the way. So 4 out of 5, the technical and movie aspects aside, let's get on the social commentary. Now, yes, this is a film about gentrification. Gentrification is, to me, the most serious issue of our time. A lot of issues stem from gentrification. Such as, you know, there's a police shooting in the movie. And yes, police shootings have been happening before gentrification, but we don't have to get into the aspects of lowering and raising property values, and the police come in to try to, now that the higher income residents are gentrifying the area and different things like that. But besides gentrification, well, okay, as far as the gentrification aspect, you have Miles and Colin. They're basically movers. They work for a moving company. And I think that was a very somewhat genius idea to have that be their jobs, because that is one of the main focal points of gentrification, which is displacement. So to have them being the people that are actually moving these people out, where you can see, you know, there's remnants of family history, photographs, pictures of people who were longstanding residents of the community, different things like that. So you're able, and we can all relate to moving. For the most part, we all have moved at least one time at some point of our lives, whether we wanted to or didn't want to. So that's something that we can all kind of relate to, so to speak. So I thought that was a very, very genius idea to have them be moving people. I don't think I've really seen that in the movie, and it might not have normally worked in a movie besides this one. So that was a very, very great fit. Now, besides gentrification, you have Colin dealing with reentry. He's a convicted felon. So you have him with his parole officer and his countdown to being off of probation, and trying to stay the straight and narrow path, and the difficulty of that while trying to be a regular, normal citizen. Basically, his reentry into society, all the while trying not to re-enter back into the prison system. He's in a halfway house for the better half of the first half of the film. So that you have that issue besides gentrification. And at some point, you have Miles and Colin, they begin fighting amongst each other. And, you know, is it harder for Colin to live in a black community dealing with the police? Or is it harder for Miles, the white guy from Oakland, to deal with being white in an all black, in a majority black community? So you have that going, coming to a head, and you have Colin, who basically seems like a good person, who continues to stick up for Miles, and at the expense of his sometimes could be safety and being convicted, different things like that. You'll see it when you see the movie. So a lot of issues. There's like photography of the people who live there in the communities, and their self portraits and different things of people. The film does a very good job of capturing, I guess, the essence of Oakland. Like, what does Oakland represent as far as before gentrification and now after gentrification, as far as even the difference between Raider fans and Golden State Warriors fans? And I think that's a perfect analogy, because even being here all the way in the Midwest, we know Oakland Raiders. We know the diehard Raider fans, no matter, you know, how much they've been through. But those Raider fans are symbolic of the long-standing residents in these Oakland communities, whereas the Golden State Warriors fans can kind of represent the bandwagoners, the hipsters, the tech people, the people who are a part of the gentrification. So you have that, where in the beginning of the film, the opening is very good, very beautiful. You just see the contrast between cultures, the cultural clash between black long-standing residents and those who gentrify the community. And it's very good from the beginning. The intention is so you can see what the contrast is. And, you know, they try to go to a party midway through the film, about three-fourths way through the film. It doesn't work out. And they tell Miles, the white guy, to leave the house, leave the neighborhood, leave the house party. And, you know, he gets upset and he says, "No, you get out of here." Saying that they need to leave the neighborhood because it was like a hipster kind of party. They did a good job of it. It's just the film, it exposes. It opens the conversation. That's what a great film does. It begins to, it sparks dialogues and conversations that we should have within our community. And there's a lot of different topics. You have the Blue Lives Matters in this community. You have the protest, and you have the pictures of when people get killed, how they show the picture of them in the orange jail jumpsuits instead of a regular picture. There's just every little detail, the little kid being trained how to deal with the police. And it's just, you know, in a short amount of time, the film, I think, covers a lot of good bases. And I think it's a really good film, because I think it spans a variety of audiences. It's trying to reach, you can see teenagers watching it, you can see adults watching it, and it's very lighthearted, but the serious is serious enough where it's not too serious. So very well balanced, very well done film. And let me get back to the gentrification. We need more films like these. I hope this film begins to start some kind of movement. I hope you support this film so other films like this can be made, so we can start discussing this issue. Because gentrification, it does not seem to be talked about and discussed enough as far as the other issues. And, you know, that's not good to me, because And we understand why, because gentrification is not, as I say, it's not as appealing, it's not as action, it doesn't have enough action in it to capture people's attention spans as something that's a quick news story, someone getting shot or the police planting false evidence or, you know, different things like that. It's more of, it can be a long drawn out, but it's systematic, it affects everyone. And it's tearing apart families. It's, you know, so that's my take on the movie. Again, a 4 out of 5. I highly recommend it. The ending could have been better, but it was good how it ended. But that's why I gave it a 4. The script was good. I thought some of the parts might have been kind of corny, somewhat. But as far as the social commentary, it was great. I think it got the message across where there's a distinct difference between the cultures of people who are gentrifying neighborhoods and people who live there. In fact, there's someone that was killed or shot by the police. And there was a mural, and they show a group of 3 white people walking down the street at night, and they just walk past the mural. The main character, Colin, he's watching these white people. He's looking at the mural, and then 3 white people walk past the mural, and they don't even look twice. They don't even look at the pictures. They don't look at the candles. They don't look at anything. It's like it didn't even happen. It's like they didn't stop and say, well, who is this? Or I think we've seen him on the news, or you know what I mean? So it's showing like, okay, they're invested for their own, their own gain. They don't really care about the residents for the community. And that's just like a quick 5 to 10 seconds of the film. So there's a lot of small different things like that can spark these conversations that we need to have in our community. So stay tuned for more Melanated Media news, where alternative thinking is as simple as breathing.